There are some options available with calculated data that we just didn't look at before. And I'll tell you, these options they're pretty complex. I would always suggest, if you've got questions about these, take a look at the online help, especially when it comes to things like our expression sampling. We'll demonstrate that today, but it's an obscurity that when it comes down to it, there's really no replacement for looking at specifics when it comes to how that function works. For example, on online help, I can go in here, just do expression sampling. This is a topic from calculated data. And this expression sampling mode is described in much greater detail here. So anyway, that's where you can find more information. Let's just start from the beginning and look at some of these advanced functions from the simplest to the most complex. If you recall, calculated data allows me to do a calculation, and also I can do filtering at the time I do that calculation. We'll start with a simple calculation. I'd like that calculation to appear here. And although I could retrieve, let's say, some one-hour averages or something like that, I think I'm just going to look at a day total here, so I'm not going to choose a time interval. So let me prepare here to do an average of CDT158 for the most recent 24 hours ending this morning at 7 a.m. Now to do that, as we've seen earlier, if you leave this blank, we will only do one calculation, and then you choose the type of calculation you want. Average in this case. We'll leave these blank for right now, the filter expression. Now, this is the option we haven't seen before. It's called Advanced. And the first thing you'll notice is that we have been defaulting so far to time-weighted calculations. Whenever you do a calculation, it's a time-weighted calculation. This is showing me 159 as the time-weighted average. Now, by time-weighted, that's kind of like looking at the area underneath the curve and averaging all that. Now, you can just do a straight average, a straight calculation in which you just add up the numbers and divide by the number of values in the archive. And that would be, instead of a time-weighted, that would be event-weighted. If I change this over to event-weighted, you'll notice the result changes slightly. We should expect them to be fairly close to each other. So with time-weighted, what we were doing was, essentially, taking a value, interpolating a value for every single second within that period of time, adding up all those numbers, and then dividing by the number of seconds. And that was a time-weighted average. This is an event-weighted average, and it simply adds up the numbers and then divides by the numbers of values that you find in the archive for that tag. So a nice way of illustrating this would be to use a different calculation. Let's go into this definition here. And instead of doing an average, let's do a count. Now the count means simply the count of values the number of values that are in the calculation. And if I choose count, you see we end up with 241 values. That indicates that there were 241 instances of CDT158 between yesterday and today at 7. And we could verify this very quickly by going in here and doing compressed data. Let's just choose tag name, start time, and end time. And we should see we'll show the timestamps. We should see 241 values. Yeah, there we go. See, we come back with 241. So if we simply switch this over to count, that's going to show us that what we're doing here is it's event-weighted. It's based on the number of events, in this case 241 values. Now watch what happens if I make this simple change to time-weighted instead of event-weighted. Remember, we're looking at count. This actually is kind of showing, kind of under the hood of what Pi is actually doing for the calculation. It comes back as 86,400. You may recognize that's the number of seconds in one day. So what it's actually doing, when it's event-weighted, it actually will interpolate a value for each and every second in that day, add them all up, and then divide by 86,400. And I show you this by way of illustrating what's actually going on under the hood. So the time-weighted versus event-weighted is it's an option that's only available within this advanced calculated data. Normally, with all the other calculations, by default, they will be time-weighted. Now, let me go ahead and change this back to an average.